Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. I want to share how wonderful God really is. We don't realize how fair and just He is. A lot of us get offended. This is how crazy things have gotten in these last days. A lot of us, not us, but a lot of people get offended by God's do's and don'ts, by His yays and His nays, because we want to follow our own ways, not His. So what we end up doing is we throw out the old and we take in what we think things ought to be. And we take on the rules and regulations of the laws of chaos, which means anything goes. There are no lines of demarcation. There are no differences between right and wrong. The lines are blurred. The values are blurred, and we don't have an idea which way to go because everyone says, do your thing. Do whatever comes to your mind to do. I don't care how bizarre. I don't care how abominable. I don't care how sickening. No matter how disgusting, how harmful, do it. But that's not the way God's ways are. When we say this is the way I was born this way. I was born to lie. I was born to live gay. I was born to rape. I was born to violence. I was born to sickness. I was born to insanity. What God's word says is, you must be born again. Those are the words of Jesus Christ Himself. And then God's words back Him up by saying, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So when you're born again, that means all the old stuff that you were born with originally are done away with. How are they done away with? Through prayer, through a relationship with God, through self-discipline, dying to your old self and living to your new self. Granting your new self its ability to thrive and grow and blossom into this new you. But you never do that if you're so busy living to the percepts of what you used to be. You have to drive out the old. That takes effort on your part. And the problem with this society is they don't want to put forth effort. And because they don't want to put forth effort, anything goes, because this world loves the path of least resistance, which means your child can do whatever your child wants to do, even no matter how much it means they disobey you, even if it means they abuse you, even if it means they disrespect you. It doesn't matter, because anything goes. And who are we to pull in the reins of our children? Well, as parents, that is your job. But it causes for resistance. And we don't want resistance, so even parents take the path of least resistance. And while our children are trying to figure out who they are, we are not doing any good because we let them do whatever comes to their mind to do. And the children end up raising the parents. The children end up ruling over the parents. The children are the puppet masters, and the parents or the puppets. It's a total reversal of God's design for family structure, for family function. Ah, okay. The sad part is that is why children have no respect for authority, because authority has given up. They have given up their right to rule. They have given up their dominion. And anytime you give up, listen, there's an old expression. It's not a scripture. It's an old expression. It's a wise proverb that says, if you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything. And that's what this world is doing. They will not stand for God and His ways. We're falling for everything. God help us.
because it calls.